this hand. And similarly, we have to send this hand back. The only thing this hand beats is an empty the Warrens. Okay, we can keep this. We're not excited about it. Like, we don't have any pressure. We don't really have much to do. But if he doesn't go for a turn one, we can set up a nice brainstorm on turn two. And hopefully fix our hand. If he goes for a turn one, we just have to pitch the brainstorm to force a will. Because drawing three cards towards a blue card is miserable. Like, if you brick, you just lose the game. That's not really a gamble I want to take. He kept his opening seven. That kind of sucks for us. Our opponent has been playing competent. It's been a good match. I think I'm favored overall. I've beaten this matchup before. Okay. So if he has probe and like a mana morphos, he might not even have the win in hand. The game we won, we not only had force of will though, we also had relevant pressure. And we were able to kill him on turn four. This hand is going to be very unlikely to kill him on turn four. I want to force that Chromox so hard. Sometimes it's correct. I don't think it is here. Permanent sources of mana are so good in that deck. Because, like, if you after the first Belcher gets forced, it makes the second one way more castable. If you're playing Rug and you don't stifle a Chromox out of Belcher, you are probably making a mistake. I mean, Stifle is also good against Empty the Warrens and Belcher, but, I mean, it's not that good against Belcher. Alright, activate it next turn. It's really, like, if you see a Chromox, you should just stifle it. Similarly, if it's, like, game one and you're staring at an Abrupt Decay or something and they go Chromox, you should Abrupt Decay it with the trigger on the stack. You should not let that puppy resolve. So he's thinking about what he wants to imprint. He eventually chooses Autumn's Veil. It's a good sign for us. He's just doing this so he doesn't have to discard. He doesn't have a win through Force of Will yet. I'm actually going to fire off Brainstorm right now. Even if we miss, like, he's playing around Force of Will, I think even if we miss hitting on a blue card, he'll still play around it. So this Brainstorm feels fairly safe to me. We also have a good chance of just finding a blue card, which we did. Alright, what do we want to put on top? I think I'm just going to fetch Noble Hierarch. Do I want to put away the other two fetches, though? That's the real consideration. The other option is shuffling away Soul of the Harvest. And so it's like, will Soul of the Harvest be relevant this game? It's very difficult to tell. We have a lot of mana here, though. I'm going to do this. This line is a little bit awkward if we draw a Bloodbraid Elf next turn, or like a Misthollow Griffin, before hitting other mana sources. Oh. That's not what I meant to do. Whatever, this is still fine. It's possible that activating Deathrite Shaman is just what we're doing next turn, so. If we have to hold Shardless Agent for Force of Will. Alright, well, I think he just wins. Imprints Empty the Warrens. So we could still draw Plague. Kind of wishing I had shuffled away this Soul of the Harvest now. Also kind of wishing that I had countered his Chrome Mox, but if I had done that, he might have just been able to make Empty the Warrens that turn, whereas waiting slowed him down a turn. Now it's a race to find Plague. So our opener with the Engineered Plague would have been very good against this hand, but it wouldn't have done anything to a Belcher, which is why I didn't even bother. Yeah, I'm just going to cast Charless Agent and hope it does good things for me. Because we could still win this game. We could very much still win this game. Especially drawing Food Chain there. We really just need to find a way to get a Griffin into our hand. Of course, we took out all of our Manipulate Fates, but still all these Brainstorms. Oh god, can't really use any of this. And no shuffle effect. Can't even cast Deathrite Shaman because we heard basic island. I hate basics so much. If we could play Deathrite Shaman here, I think we'd actually be in kind of reasonable shape. As is, I think we just lose. We were at 18 and now we're at 5, so he hit us for 13. Meanwhile, we can go Food Chain 4, 5, 6, 7. Click us, cantrip, draw Force of Will. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Get Soul of Harvest, draw 2 cards. But I can't really do anything with that mana because I can only spend creature, like I can only cast creatures off of it. So I think he just wins. Although 12 is exactly enough to go Soul of the Harvest into Misthollow Griffin. Ah, man, I passed a Misthollow Griffin on that cascade with Shardless Agent 2 as the next card. Yeah, I guess let's see if we can get there. Well, actually, Deathrite Shaman can gain me 2 life up to 7. And if I block 4 of them, I'm taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, it's unfortunate. Oh, if the Vendilion click is cantripping for me, then I'm not casting one of these other cards. Yeah, I think, yeah, he just wins. Yeah, that was like, kind of an unfortunate brainstorm. Off the cascade. Not finding us, Griffin. Or Plague. Like, Plague would have been amazing, obviously. This doesn't do anything. Alright, I'm just gonna scoop it up here. But I'm gonna draw a card first. Yeah. Nice combo, right? Yeah. Alright. excellent match, good finals. Opponent played very well. I was happy. I think we made good mulligan decisions. Most of the Belcher matchup is making accurate mulligan decisions because the game is so compacted in the first couple of turns. Obviously, if we had like put him on an Empty the Warren's hand, keeping Engineered Plague on the play, just wins. But then we just lose the 50% of the games that he has a Belcher with the opener that we had. So I thought going for a Force of Will was better. Knowing that he's competent and like has probes in his deck and like all these Xanted Swarms and stuff, maybe it's not correct to keep looking for Force of Will like that. But we're also looking for Needle, so there's that too. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed it. See you all next week. Pretty happy with the food chain list. After playing the deck a lot, like I said earlier, I ran it in like 3 dailies, cashed 2 of them, played in a lot of 2-mans. I'm up in the 2-mans as well. The deck's like, it's not overpowered or anything, but you can certainly win with it. It's got game. Probably like a little bit worse than just regular shardless, especially in the fair deck mirror, like when you're playing other shardless decks. But it's probably better than shardless in some matchups. Like I was able to combo people out earlier, which obviously normal shardless can't do. So the main things I'm working on right now are like whether I want this Caracas in the main deck. I probably don't. Another tropical or a fetch would probably be way better than this Caracas. Probably another tropical. And then in the sideboard, I have been very happy with Counterbalance. I've been less than happy with Submerge and less than happy with Venser. So I think the Submerges might become Meek Stones and the Venser's just going to become a second Counterbalance. Because there are a lot of matchups where I just like having a blind Counterbalance in play. The deck finds Brainstorm often enough with all the Cascaders that you can set it up a reasonable amount of time. And then just blind hitting in the matchups where it's good happens often enough that it's still worth it. You only need to counter like 1 or 2 spells for Counterbalance to be worth it. So there it is. Yeah, see you guys next week.